Hello all, welcome back to my review series. Today's review is about the Bugatti Chiron. This has been one of the best cars in the game and now it is available in store when you reach garage level 18. This is a very very nice car and it is good for even touch drivers to use, and for manuals it is of course a beast. So as you can see, the stats are pretty decent. The nitro is also decent, acceleration is amazing, the top speed is nice. It does have some physics issues, but you know, you even after a wreck you will still win 90% of the times in Rush series. It's how powerful this car is. So we shall see today how this car performs in the Rush series in overall tracks. I have not seen any track in which this car has a disadvantage. It creates phenomenal times in absolutely almost all of the tracks. So this is a very nice car. It is one of the free to play cars which you can get, and it is of course the free to play king. So we shall go now in multiplayer and see how it performs. So again, as any other classes car, Floaty 360 and Floaty Drift work on this car. You also have to make sure about the wall rides. Wherever you can wall ride, you have to. Of course, there's a chance of some fails, but yeah, it is a very nice car overall. Also, it requires about 16 epics to for golden. Mine is currently golden, so you shall see its performance now. The acceleration and nitro really helps to maintain this car speed over 400. It is much easier to drive than the Jesco, so you know, it's a nice car that way. As you can see, the speed, you know, shoots up. Under a minute, this track. Very nice run. Also, as you can see, you can customize the body parts of this car. The body parts can be available through multiplayer rewards, so make sure you collect them all. Again, the same track. Again under 1 minute. Also, this car sets very comparable times in class S Elite. It sets times almost equivalent to Jesco. So if you guys don't have it at max, just keep on buying the blueprints from the shop. It is a very nice car, and it is worth it. It is a little expensive to upgrade and max, but every bit of this car is worth it. Seconds. That's nice. Under a minute tracks now. All of these. Nice. Good tracks. Time to kill. Again a good time. As you can see, this car is very, very powerful. But of course, in some races, you are bound to fail with this car. Because of maybe some physics issues. So far, so good. I haven't had any physics issues with this car. similar time. Okay, good. Let's see how much time this car makes over here. I'm guessing 102 or 101 if it's a nice start, of course. Good time. Even after that failed start. As you can see, this car is pretty nice overall. I don't see a fault in it. Sometimes the physics can be bad, but it is a beast. And it is a very nice car to have. It also looks good. So hopefully, I hope you all can max it. It is a very nice car to have, and I think total of 200 blueprints are required to max this car, and 16 epics. And each epic from store is for 15,000 trade coins. So I hope this review helps you all to decide, whether to spend it or not. But in my opinion, you should spend everything for this car. It is very nice. So until next time, I'll say a goodbye for now. Whoever is new to this channel, please subscribe. I am close to reaching 1,000 subscribers. I would like to thank you all for the support that you have provided. And have a good day. Bye-bye.